Hello, hello, testing. Lectern mic.
We are woven. We are a church of churches, a family of families, a community of communities. We are woven together for one purpose, the adventure of following Jesus. We are the young at heart. Children, young people, students, young adults, grown-ups, the wise. We are worshipping, praying, serving, loving, helping, embracing, giving, noisy, silent. We are praying, we are hoping, we are calling Nottingham to the wonder and way of Jesus. We are woven. You are invited.
Wonderful. Well, good morning and welcome to all of you. My name is Rich and I lead Woven. Welcome if you're from Woven St. Margaret's. It's great to see you this morning. Welcome if you're from Woven St. Leo's. Fabulous to see you. Woven St. Aidan's. Lovely that you're here in Woven St. Martha's and any of the other Woven churches. If you snuck in with us this morning, it's wonderful to see you this morning. We were just praying before the service and talking about how we're longing to see God's Spirit with every single one of us in this building, and but also where you are at home, and just expectant for all that God's going to do amongst us. And I was thinking this morning, as we start this service, there's so much bad news around, isn't there? It's very hard to not be surrounded at the moment with bad news. And so I thought, if you're at home and you've got access to the chat, why didn't you put one thing in the chat this morning that you're thankful for? What's one thing that you are thankful for this morning? Because I thought it'd be really encouraging for us all to almost surround ourselves with thankfulness of the things that God is doing, with the blessings in our lives, with the good things surrounding us. So maybe just take a moment and pop in the chat what you're thankful for. I'm going to pray and then we're going to leap into action worship. And I mean leap in here in church this morning. It's freezing because we've not got the heating on. And so we're all desperately excited about action worship because it means we get to move a bit and go for it. And so I hope at home you're ready to go as well. So let me pray and then we're going to jump out of our seats and we're going to go for it using our whole bodies to worship Jesus this morning. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning that we can celebrate you, that you are good, that you do good things, that you surround us with good things. You are such a good God to us, our good Heavenly Father. And thank you that we can worship and praise you this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. And so hop up out your seats, particularly kids, let's go. And Nicole is going to come and lead us in, I'm going to socially distance away, lead us in action worship. So let's go, guys.
Jesus, you are here with me. Jesus, you are all I need. I will follow where you lead me. I will worship you. So I clap, Amazing. That actually has really warmed me up. Whew. Good morning, everybody. This morning in Woven Kids TV, well, we've been doing all through history, so we've been continuing our series, and we were looking at Samson and how he gives us strength, and some of the kids have also got craft packs that went along with that. If you're new and you're a family, you'd love to get involved with what we do with Woven Kids, please be in touch. Wovenkids@wearewoven.church. I'm out of breath. Oh, my goodness. But we are super excited to continue being online together as Woven Kids. The link is on the Woven Church YouTube page. It's going to be there the whole week, so feel free to catch up if you've missed it. And we'd love to be able to see you there. I'm going to pass over to the worship team. Oh, no, to Rich.
To me.
It's to me, to you.
It's doing slightly differently this morning. So you're back to me. I love the Woven Kids TV stuff. Our family are enjoying that. So I hope you are at home too, whatever age you are. That's the thing. I have an excuse because I've got kids, but you know, no one's going to know. If you get on YouTube and get in there and watch it, it's great fun and really good. So hopefully everyone's enjoying that. Now we're going to do the order slightly differently this morning. And so instead of going into worship, which is what we'd normally do this morning, we're actually going to break up the talk into a few sections to help us engage and to sort of mix it up a little bit this morning. So I'm going to pray and we're going to hear the first little section of Lydia leading us into our new series, Looking at Prayer. So let's take a moment to pray together. Lord, I pray that you would speak to us this morning through all the sections of this service. And as we open your word together, God, may our hearts be open in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to the sermon slot of our service. Just a big shout out to all of our Woven churches gathered and watching today. And today we are going to begin our series looking at prayer. And over the next few weeks we're going to look at all sorts of realities around prayer. This amazing gift that God has given to us so that we can chat to him, get to know him, we can hear from him, we can really say to him, gosh, this is hard in the world right now. So we'll be looking at things like kind of sacrifice and self-discipline. We'll be looking at rhythms of prayer and how we can pray as individuals and how we can pray together as a church. We'll be looking at the power of prayer as we believe that prayer does change things. But this morning we are going to begin by just taking a step back and considering, what is prayer? What is prayer? And we're going to do that by looking at the first few verses of the Lord's Prayer. And if you've ever kind of said the Lord's Prayer, whether it's at school or whether it's a sort of Wednesday communion service or in a church when we gather together, you'll probably know Matthew's account. And actually, the Lord's Prayer is recorded by two of the gospel writers. And the gospel writers were just people who knew of Jesus and recorded his life. And both Matthew and Luke record the Lord's Prayer, the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples, his friends, his followers. We're going to use Luke this morning, and Luke is a slightly shorter version, so as we read it together you might think, oh, a little bit different, but that's okay. There's some stuff that we're going to press into today as we consider what prayer is. So if you've got a Bible, do you turn to it, whether that's a kind of physical Bible like I've got here, or whether you've got a phone, or there's something up on your TV screen, equally the verses will come up on the screen behind me. And turn to Luke chapter 11, verses 1 to 4. Luke chapter 11, verses 1 to 4. Which say, one day, Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples. He said to them, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, give us each day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone who sins against us. And lead us not into temptation. Let's pray for a moment. Father, we thank you, you're good. And Jesus, we thank you that you gave us this prayer, a model prayer, and that you call us into relationship with you. And there's such excitement and joy in that. And so what is prayer? Well, here we've got this amazing model. These words that Jesus offered to his friends, to us as his followers, as the church. And in one sense, you might look at those and go, okay, brilliant, box ticked, that's how to pray, let's just read those words. But actually, there is so much more going on. And there's two things that jump out in those first lines, verses 1 and 2. And the first thing is this cry of Father, Father, hallowed be your name. Matthew's translation says, our Father in heaven. Our Father in heaven. The fact that actually we can get up close to God, that he calls us into relationship with him, that prayer allows us to have a close, close relationship with God. And then there's the first verse, as the disciples come to Jesus and they just say, teach us how to pray. And Jesus enters into a kind of conversation, a chat with them. And we see that Jesus, God, wants to partner with them. And so those are the two things that are the basis of prayer. A closeness to God, a kind of intimacy, a relationship, the fact that we can come to God, and a partnership with God, the fact that he wants to work in and through and with us. And so let's just consider for a moment this whole idea of being close to God. It's a kind of mad idea, isn't it? That like God Almighty, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the Lord of all the universe, wants to have a friendship and a relationship with us, wants to come close to us, says, actually, you can call me Father. You can cry, Father in heaven. And as I was thinking about this, I was reflecting on my own life, but I was also reminded of a young guy I used to work with. A few years ago, I was a youth worker, and one of the young people in my youth group was a guy called Dimitri. He would be fine with me telling you this story. And Dimitri had quite a kind of difficult life and things, and then he really radically, but slightly slowly, came to faith. I first met him at an open youth club that we were running, we were just playing a lot of pool together on things. And I basically bribed him to come to church with Starbucks. So I meet him at Starbucks beforehand, get him some sort of frappuccino type situation. And then I'd be like, come on, let's go to evening service. And slowly he got to know who God was. And then he had a really sort of radical encounter with Jesus one evening. But then the thing was his walk with God after that. And as I kind of chatted with him, he was struggling with prayer. He didn't mind kind of like praying to God if God felt really up there and really other. But the idea of praying to a God who was his Father and who wanted to be in relationship with him and who he could come close to was a struggle for him. He'd had difficult relationships in his life. His parents had not been great. A lot of his friends, he'd found it quite difficult to relate to them because of the way that he'd sort of grown up. And I watched him over weeks and months and spending some time with an associate vicar that I worked with at that church, who had been through similar things in years before that. And I watched them kind of grappling together and Dimitri learning how to pray and learning how to be close to God and learning how to shout and be annoyed when he needs to be and to kind of shout in joy and be really happy when he needs to be and learning to pray. And it transformed him. Became just a really, really different person, amazing youth leader and role model. Actually learning how to pray, Our Father in heaven. Learning that prayer was about a closeness with God, that he could come close to God. Learning what the disciples learned all these years ago, what Jesus has taught us to pray, Our Father in heaven. Changed everything for Dimitri. And it can change everything for us as we remember or begin to know or run out with the fact that God is a God who wants to be close to us. And in prayer, we come close to God and he comes close to us. And so that's challenge number one this morning. Actually, how are you doing with being close to God? Are you getting to know his voice? And are you offering your voice to him? So we're going to pause there and we're going to come back in a little while and we're going to think about partnering with God.
Wonderful. We are going to worship God now. And I'm just going to lead us in with that start of the Lord's Prayer. And let's just remember that God is close to you this morning. I don't know what you bring this morning, whether you've had the most amazing, wonderful, brilliant week, or whether actually this last week's been really hard and really difficult. And I love that as Lydia was leading us through that part of the Lord's Prayer, she reminded us that God's really close, whether it's been an amazing week, whether you feel really close to him, or whether it's been a tough week and you feel really distant, he is really close to you this morning. And so we're going to worship God together. And as we worship, just know God's closeness. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven. Our Father in heaven. Hallowed be your name. Thank you this morning that you are close to us. You're interested in our lives. You're interested in what's going on for us. And as we lift our voices now to sing your praise, to worship you, God, I thank you that you're close, not distant. Amen. Let's worship. You may want to stand, but definitely let's sing, because at least we can do that at home. And let's worship God together.
Oh, Worship and praise you. We thank you for your peace, that peace that passes all understanding. You are our everything, our rock, and our firm foundation. Amen. The response this morning will be, we wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. And during these prayers, there will be silent moments to bring your own prayers to the Lord. We all intercede in different ways, and it's wonderful that the Lord gets variation. So we thank you that you can join us now at home and be part of these prayer times. So let us bow our head in prayer. Let us bring our cares and worries, hurt and pain, sadness and loss, frustrations and loneliness before our God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son Jesus Christ to hear us when we pray in faith. And as a faith-filled church, we come into your presence now. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come be with us now, in this moment, in this time of prayer. Guiding our thoughts and our hearts. Draw us into your throne room in worship, thanking you in every situation, worshipping you in every area of our lives. We believe in the power of worshipping you. We know that your truth dwells in a worshipping heart. We offer you a sacrifice of praise right now. blessed be your name, O God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen, who made all things perfect, King of kings, Lord of lords, our rock and our salvation. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come into our presence. Be in our homes and in our hearts. So many cares and worries, Lord, for every man, woman, and child in these strange times. Those working in all areas of health and social care. Parents having to homeschool. The loss of jobs. We bring these cares and worries before you, Lord, and pray you take the stresses and strains, bringing peace. We hope in the Lord. He is our help and our shield. So much hurt and pain. We are a hurting world, Lord, with so much pain. Bring peace to this needy world. Distrust and conflict. Disease and hunger. Persecution and destruction. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. So much sadness and loss. We come before you, Lord, for those living with grief, the loss of a loved one, for the terminally ill, for those who live with pain. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Lord of all life, hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. We also think of their families, Lord, but at this time we'll probably be pausing and thinking of those that have gone before. So we think of Maud Hilda Archer. Brenda Healy. Sir Benedict Sundy C. Agodosi. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Father, we praise you that when we are weak, we can rely on your strength. When we are poor in spirit, you fill us with joy. When we are empty, you flood our lives with peace. When we are hurting, you hold us in your care. When we are breaking or broken, you make us whole. You are our God, and we worship and praise your holy name. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. I think we can all amen those prayers, can't we? Well, I'm using a double mic now. Hold on, let me turn one off. Amen. Wonderful. I loved how June just led us in prayer then, as we, you know, we want to, one of the things we're praying about this before the service again was we want to be a praying church, don't we? And my prayer is that that's one of the things God is leading us into, is to keep growing in prayer. And we can always grow in prayer. So a few notices, just things to let you know about. I know there's even more than this going on around the church, but just a few things to let you know about. Firstly, post service Zoom. So if you would like to join in for, usually after church, and all of our churches would get together, have a cup of coffee and see each other. And one of the things we're missing is seeing each other. And I've been loving seeing your thanksgivings, by the way. I know that some of you have been saying, I'm so thankful for the technology. That means we can stay in touch at this time. And other people, Janine was thankful for firemen. If you haven't seen the chat, I'm just going to leave it there. You can wonder what on earth is going on. Also, people were thankful for Nicole's dancing, but mine, not so much. I think that's probably fair. Okay. Anyway, feel free to keep putting Thanksgivings in. It's lovely to see what's been going on for you guys. But we'd love to see you all. So after the service, there's going to be a post-service Zoom. The details are going to appear in the chat right now. You can jump onto that and just, we'll be put into little breakout rooms and just have a moment, just have a coffee. You can come for a short time. If you've just got a couple of minutes, feel free to log in. If you've got kids running around like everywhere, don't worry, it's allowed to be chaos. That's the end of church is usually chaos, so we're trying to replicate a bit of chaos online. So please do feel free to join with the after church Zoom. Food Bank, as you know, Food Bank is one of our key ministries here at St. Margaret's, particularly Woven St. Margaret's. I know that Woven St. Martha's also have a food bank, but there's particular needs here for the St. Margaret's Food Bank. Thank you so much to everybody. I know June would echo this. Thank you so much to everyone who's donated and filled the shelves before Christmas, but we've got a lot of people coming into the food bank now in early January. Popped in myself, saw some people, saw how busy June, Alan and the team were, and we're so thankful for all of you if you volunteer at Food Bank. But there's a few things that we particularly need. So long life milk, tinned beef and ham, custard, razors, and just anything else. You know the normal things for Food Bank. We would love it if we can all just keep that on the radar, keep donating to Food Bank. It's one of our key ministries, particularly at this moment. Which leads me into debt advice. As you know, we're hoping to open up debt advice to run at a similar time as Food Bank's going on. And we're partnering with Trent Vineyard and the debt centre they have here, that we can and have debt advice running out of here at St. Margaret's, and hopefully in some of the other churches as well. But what we really need are some people who would like to volunteer, and you'd be trained up to help people go through a bit of a journey to learn and how to work out of debt. And so if you would like to volunteer, if you'd like to help out with that ministry, if you would get in touch with Lynn Kent. You can email Lynn at lynn.kent@wearewoven.church. She would love to hear from you and can tell you exactly what that all means. So just by ringing up, doesn't mean you're signed up, but you can just find out what it's all about and whether it might be a fit for you. But we'd love for some of us to be trained up to be debt volunteers. And the final thing, and I'm really excited about this, we are running a quiz. And this is for Woven St. Margaret's, but anybody is welcome. In this particular moment, we're opening the doors. Anybody is welcome to join in to the big fat, I don't know why we called it a fat quiz, but we have. I don't know if that's something to do with my, overindulgence over Christmas. Anyway, there you go. Big fat quiz of the year, Saturday, 23rd of January, 2021. You're so welcome. It's going to be on Zoom. Usually we'd do lots of fun things around this time of year, but obviously we can't get together, but we can get together on Zoom, and we'll have a quiz, have some fun, and we would love everybody to join in, and they'll pop the link that you can sign up, so you can sign up. Oh, the only reason you have to sign up is so that we can send you all the right details, and we don't just put the details of the Zoom out on the internet, because then anyone could come and join in. We're just going to let you know. So please do sign up for that. We've already got a load of people signed up. Don't miss out. We'd love to see as many of us there as possible. I think that's all of the notices for now. So I'm going to pray, and we're going to go into our second part of our sermon this morning. Lydia's going to continue that journey looking at prayer in a short little segment. So let me pray for us, and then Lydia's going to take us on. Heavenly Father, thank you that you're speaking to us about prayer so much this morning. And Lord, I pray that you would continue to speak to us as Lydia speaks to us now. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, welcome back, guys. So what we're going to consider now is what it looks like to partner with God. We've considered just how we can get close to God and the importance of that in prayer, and how prayer releases and sort of enables our relationship with God. And now we look at partnering with God in prayer. And if we flip back to verse 1 in our reading from Luke, we'll see in that verse that it says, one day Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples. And so he said to them, when you pray, say, our Father in heaven. And it was totally normal for disciples to ask Jesus that. It was totally normal for Jesus to say, hey, this is how you pray, this is how you do this thing. Jesus was a rabbi, so essentially he was a teacher and a leader. And he had some disciples who were basically his kind of followers, his pupils, his friends. And in the first century, that's what happened all the time. Rabbis, teachers, leaders had disciples, and disciples asked questions. We're in constant conversation, constant partnership with their leaders. But the interesting thing in this, and in this reality, is that that is the reality that God chose, has chosen, always chooses. That actually he chooses a reality where there's a conversation, where we talk to him and he talks back, where we partner with him. God's plan for the world, there's one of partnering with us. And we see that way back in the beginning of time. In the book of Genesis, God creates the world and he says it's good. And then a few verses later, he creates humankind. He creates us men and women. And he looks at us and he says, it is now very good. And he gives us the world to steward over. He partners with us to bring about his purposes in this world. And then things go wrong, we have things like, we have the fall, sin enters the world. And then all of history up to Jesus is God constantly talking to humanity, constantly partnering with people, with individuals. And then he sends Jesus. God, a human being, to work out his purposes of salvation and his purposes of partnering with us. And Jesus gives us this tool. God gives us this tool of prayer so that when Jesus went back to heaven and is in heaven now, we can continue that relationship with him. We can continue our relationship with God, partnering with God through prayer. A guy called John Mark Comer, who is just a church leader at the moment in America and writes lots of books, and who I really, really like as I read his books and as I listen to some of his podcasts. He just says this: God is looking for partners. God is looking for partners. And actually, one of God's tools to partner with us is prayer, so that we can talk to him and he can talk to us. When I was a kid in Sunday school, years and years ago, I think we sang like a lot of kids, all agey type songs, but there's only one that I remember, and it went something like this. I'm not going to sing for you, but I will tell you the words. And it was like, prayer is like a telephone. Prayer is like a telephone for us to talk to Jesus. And telephones may have moved on. We don't get many of these around these days. I seem to have one because my mum and dad bought it for me, and they're the only people who ring it. I don't even really know what the number is to my home phone. Things have moved on. We tend to use these a lot more. But actually, the truth of prayer, the truth of the fact that prayer is like a telephone, it's a way that we kind of remember, we walk out, we think, okay, God, I am going to come and I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to pick up the phone. I'm going to say, hey, God, this is what's going on. Would you speak to me? Those things don't change. Words for it might change. As I've got older, sometimes I use ridiculous phrases like, I'm in the eternal conversation with God. It's the same thing. It's partnership. It's prayer. It's the fact that God wants to talk to us, and he wants us to talk to him. And as we talk to him and as we pray, he partners with us. As we come close to him, our partnership with him is walked out, and we change, and the world around us changes. So coming close to God, partnering with God, that's what prayer is all about. And we're going to pause there again for a moment. And in a little while, we'll come back and we'll briefly look at how we live this, how we walk it out. See you in a bit, guys.
Wonderful. So we're going to take a moment. We're just going to sing. We're going to worship together another song about God's goodness, and take a moment to just reflect on the reality that we partner with a really good God. A God who comes to love us, and we change as we pray. And I don't know about you, but as June was leading us in prayer earlier, I was just joining with those prayers and almost sensing God's spirit come and meet me as June was leading us in prayer and having that sense of partnership. So maybe take a moment this morning as we worship to allow God to connect with you and to just generate that sense of partnering with him this morning as we worship him together. Thank you. Into our final little segment of the talk this morning. So take a moment just to listen to Lydia lead us through the final segment of our talk.
Well, welcome back, guys. In the next few weeks, we are going to look in a kind of deeper way at the length and the breadth of prayer, as I said in the beginning. And we're going to look at lots of ways that we can kind of live this well, that we can live our prayer life well. But as to date, we've just thought about coming up close to God and partnering with God. I wanted to end with just a couple of really practical sort of challenges and ways to live well in terms of prayer. And the first thing is that, as I said in the beginning, you might read the Lord's Prayer and go, right, brilliant, set, tick, there's a formula, there's some set works for prayer, that's my prayer life sorted. And the Lord's Prayer is amazing. And it's God-given, and we should pray it with joy and with integrity. But what it points to isn't that prayer is a formula, and there's a set load of words that we pray in order to get God to kind of maybe do what we want him to do or to please God. It points to the fact that God wants that relationship, that partnership, that closeness with us. And I know in my own prayer life, sometimes I thought, gosh, if I can just get the right words or something, then it'll all be good and God will do this and my life and world will be smoother. And I was talking to one of my best friends about this at the beginning of the week. And she said that she was really reminded that when she first became a Christian, she very radically changed her life. It was about 10 years ago. And she decided to move to a different city. But in so doing, she didn't have anywhere to live and she didn't have a job. And it took about 6 months for her to get a job and to get a kind of like permanent place to live that she felt was the right space and place. And in that 6 months, she was learning how to pray because she was a new Christian. And she said that she realised a couple of months in that what she was essentially doing was trying to find the perfect formula and the perfect words. And her head kind of was saying to her, right, okay, if you get the right words in the right place, it's almost like a magic trick and God will do exactly what you want and you'll get that perfect job and that perfect home. And she realised it wasn't like that. That actually, what this prayer thing was all about was her heart, and God was after her life, and God was after a conversation with her. And in his perfect time, he would work it all out. His last minute, often being a lot later than our last minute. And she found over those months that it wasn't a formula, that prayer was not about finding the right words or being in the right situation. It's about just honestly praying to God. And so the first thing that we really need to know in prayer is that it doesn't matter how long or how short our prayers are. It doesn't matter what emotions we're feeling. It doesn't matter what we say in many respects, many ways. The point is that we come in prayer and we come in honesty and then we listen to God. And sometimes that'll be in repentance, i.e. saying sorry to God because we know that we've, you know, got some things wrong. Sometimes it'll be in like, God, this is really hard. Sometimes it'll be in thanks. Sometimes it'll just be like a relaxed chat, like, oh God, this happened today. I'd like to tell you about it. What do you think? And there'll be a lot of listening. So prayer is not a formula. It's a conversation. And God just wants you to come to talk things through with him and to hear from him. Second thing is rhythms. All our rhythms have been thrown off in COVID, haven't they? And to be honest, it's like things just change week by week and it's quite difficult to get a rhythm. And we're going to talk a lot more about this next week, about how we can practically have good prayer rhythms. But I just wanted to encourage you, even this week, what is your rhythm of prayer this week? How are you praying? So prayer isn't a formula. You don't have to have the perfect words. Find your rhythm in prayer. And finally, guys, time. Give God time. Make prayer a priority. If you take one thing away from this three-part sermon today, take that away. Give God time because he's longing to give you time. He's there, he's ready, he's listening. Speak to him. So guys, the bedrock of prayer, what prayer is about being close to God, and in being close to God, it's about partnering with God. Trusting that whether your words are few or many, he hears them. Finding your rhythm in prayer and making prayer a priority as you give him time. So let's pray.
Well, it's me again in a different space. So let's take a moment to pause where we are as we draw our service to a close. We'll have a final worship song or two in a little while. But we have sung and said a lot of words this morning. So before we head out into our Sunday afternoons and our weeks to come, we just want to invite each of us, wherever we are, to pause for a moment. And we just pray. Come, Holy Spirit. Would you enliven our hearts and our minds? Would you show us what it means to pray? Our Father in heaven. And what it means to partner with you in prayer for the sake of your world. And so where you are in this moment now, just allow the Spirit to speak to you, to nudge you, to help you respond in a practical way. In this moment now, what's going to change? How is your prayer life going to be different? How are you going to come close to God? Speak to him, hear from him, partner with him. And as we gather all of this up in our final worship song, just give him your heart and allow him to change, encourage, inspire you, draw you into the depths of prayer in the days and weeks to come.
With us this morning. Lord, I pray that you teach us over these next weeks as we go through this series, Woven in Prayer. May we be woven in prayer. Lord, stir our hearts as individuals, as churches, as a church of churches. Stir us as prayers, God. We would partner with you, be close to you. Thank you, God, that you're with us. Lord, I pray that you'd fill us with your Spirit and send us out, even though most of us are out, is in. I pray that you'd send us out from this service together with you, with us, whatever our week ahead looks like. I pray that we'd send your Spirit with us every step of the way, And Lord, I pray that we'd turn our hearts to you in prayer with everything, every moment, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, it's been wonderful to see you this morning. I hope you've had as much fun as I have and enjoyed connecting with God as much as I have. And please do stay on, jump over to the Zoom right now. It should be launching any second. And we'd love to connect, have coffee together, go make yourself a cuppa and get yourself onto the Zoom. And we shall see you really soon. And do just remember, if anybody's struggling, needs some help, do feel free to give us a ring. We are here for you. So God bless. Have a fantastic week. It is, yeah, to you.